geography is everywhere, and energy is involved in everything. So I can go anywhere I want and do energy geography. I can travel around the world, which I've done. 25 years ago, I developed a term called the energy landscapes. Energy landscapes are those landscapes that have been reformed for the control of energy, development of energy. Wind turbines, such as the one that's behind me, there's tens of thousands of these wind turbines. It changes the whole look of the landscape, and that's what I'm really interested in. How does it change? How do the people react to it? So I've been working on public acceptance of these renewable energy landscapes for 30 years. I love to create new knowledge. I mean, that's part of what you're supposed to do at a university. We're supposed to be researching, pressing the envelope, creating, stimulating, moving the ball down the field.
It's pretty rare when you have a faculty member who is so good at communications, and not just communicating with scholars and colleagues and students, but communicating with the public and with the media and with legislators. I mean, he sort of has it all. And he has talked to so many different audiences about energy and energy policy that he really is a gem in the state of Arizona.
There's a couple of things that Mike and I worked on together. One is work that we did in Palestine. And there was a real interest in getting reliable energy to schools in remote areas.
I love what I'm doing. I could do this forever. What my goal is to help move the needle. And by that I mean help move the needle toward a sustainable energy future, to reduce the impact on climate change, to move toward a more benign source of energy development. We don't have a chance otherwise. And if we don't do that, my daughter is going to suffer. My grandson, who's right behind me in some of these pictures, he has no idea. I worry about that all the time. I want to make the world a better place for him and everybody like him. I worry about all those things, and all I can do is work harder, influence more kids, help them get jobs, and if everybody else does their part, we'll get there. Everything changed when I got to Riverside. Changed the trajectory of my career, changed my personal life. That's where I met my wife. I didn't meet her at Riverside, but a fellow graduate student introduced me to her. And we've been married 46 years, or as my wife would say, 146 years, depends on who's asking. I'm quite honored to be given this award. When the award comes from a prestigious university like UC Riverside, it's very humbling. But it's not just my accomplishment, it's the accomplishment of all my students. And I've got to say, it's the award that my wife has also earned. I couldn't have done it without her. You can say that luck favors the prepared, but it happens to be that J. Paul Getty is right. Rise early, work hard, and the luck will follow.